Marquez. I'm a student at the University of South Florida, and I know American Sign Language. American Sign Language, abbreviated ASL, it's a language preferred by most deaf people and the heart of the deaf community. ASL is more than just a language. It's what brings the deaf together and creates a culture within a tight-knit community. So what is deaf culture? Let's find out.
My name is Jackie. I'm a graduate student here at USF, and I'm studying upper-level education. It's been good so far. After I got my bachelor's degree, I just decided to keep going, and I'm really enjoying it. I am deaf, yes. Okay, so deaf culture. Well, in this world, people go about life doing whatever they need to do as a deaf person. How they live on a daily basis, how they communicate with people who aren't deaf, and with each other, or what makes up deaf culture. But one main thing that makes deaf culture special or unique is the language, how ASL is used to communicate. Most people think that the deaf can do nothing. I've had someone ask me before if I could drive, and I looked at them a little surprised at the question, and I told them that yes, I could drive. Then they asked me how I could hear the emergency vehicles, and I told them that it was fine. Another thing that's annoying is when people stare when they see a deaf person signing. That's not appropriate. I mean, do I stare down your mouth when you're talking? No, right? It's the same thing. Here's another one. When two deaf people are having a conversation and someone needs to walk through, then they awkwardly look at the individuals and exaggerate, "Excuse me," and then they walk underneath so they won't interrupt the conversation. That's not necessary. When hearing people are talking, they're looking around. It's the same thing with signing. They can sign around people. Those are a few things that bother me. I am the student representative of the ASL club here at USF. I help other students, and I also tell them about events that are happening in the community. I tell them when they're going to be, where they're going to be, who's invited, who can go. I also tell them where they can find the information, and those are some of my responsibilities as a student rep. It also helps them get to know the deaf people better. Here in the lab, you need to sign and you can't talk, so it's a perfect environment where students can come practice. If they have homework videos to do, they can record them on those computers. We have different books and resources available to students as well. They can come and take advantage of that, and that way they can get exposure to the deaf world and the deaf people like me and other students as well. This lab is just a great place.
My name is Asad Musa, and I'm a software engineer. Yes, I'm completely deaf. I was raised in Bombay, India. I never felt like I fit in with hearing people, but with deaf people, it's easy to feel like I belong. I've always felt more accepted by them because we share the same drive and mindset in life. I guess that's what deaf culture is all about. Growing up deaf in India was a huge challenge for me. I struggled a lot with it, even wishing I was able to hear for most of my childhood. I didn't have access to accommodations such as captions or interpreters. It's frustrating to find a job as a deaf person. Those who can hear often oppress those who can't and believe that we are unable to become professionals in fields such as medicine, engineering, and the like. America is supposed to be the land of opportunity, which is why I chose to live here. As a child, I wasn't happy being deaf. But when I moved here, I finally became proud of who I am.
How many deaf children are born to hearing parents? Ugh. I'd say it's probably higher than I would think. I'm gonna go with 10%.
Just like a roundabout, I don't know, maybe about if I had to shoot a number, maybe like 75% or so, I guess, I don't know.
Say the percentage is like a 5 to 1.
How many deaf children are born to deaf parents? I don't know. I don't know if it's something that's genetic or not, so I'd say probably a small percentage, like maybe like 3-5%.
Well, since I said 75, I'm gonna say 25% for the other part, if that makes sense.
I'd say about 3 to 1.
My name is Heather Bowers. I am a sign language interpreting major, and I'm a senior right now. As president of the ASL club at USF, I'm in charge of making sure that the officers are doing their job, and we make events every month so that we can involve the deaf community and every level of the ASL spectrum. So we have from people that don't know anything about ASL all the way to deaf people. We just show interaction with everybody so that everybody can be exposed to the community and the culture and just learn sign language as they go along. We have a Facebook page for the ASL Bulls. So we invite people to the page. We invite people to the events on the page. We also have a thing here in USF, the Bulls Market, that we promote our club and we promote our events. Deaf culture is something that I completely believe in. I guess you can say I have deaf pride, even though I'm not deaf. Just because of the interpreting program, I've learned so much about it, and that I believe that deafness is not a disability, and it's just something unique about them. Deaf culture is when the deaf community believes the same thing, and they don't believe that their deafness is a disability, and they just are proud of it, and they go on with life as a normal human being.